Jhansi Lakshmi, from JIPMER Puducherry. I have to present a paper on perforation peritonitis in an operated case of abdominal hysterectomy.
Very good morning. I am Dr. Jhansi Lakshmi, junior resident from the Department of Forensic Medicine and Toxicology. Today I am going to present a case report on perforation peritonitis in an operated case of abdominal hysterectomy. So, the medical negligence, as we all know, there is a recent rise of medical negligence cases due to an imbalanced doctor-patient relationship. Let it be due to lacking skills in diagnosis and treatment, or let it be due to delay in our treatment or improper post-operative care, let it be defective counseling. So coming into my case details, a 44-year-old woman who was diagnosed with uterine fibroid, she has underwent abdominal hysterectomy in a private clinic. However, the recovery is eventful, like she has deteriorated on post-operative day 4. Soon after this deterioration, she has been referred to a local government hospital where she has been treated for 9 more days, and later she was referred to our tertiary care center. She expired within 24 hours of admission into the tertiary care center. So on autopsy, on table, we have noticed a J-shaped sutured wound which is 12 centimeters long on the anterior surface of abdomen with intact sutures. And after opening the abdominal wall, we noticed green color discharge emitting fecal odor. So this is the picture showing the reflected abdominal flap with a greenish fluid. And there is a densely adherent mesentery and omental structures, and all these structures were coated with greenish discharge. So now we have suspected the case of hollow viscous perforation, and so the method of dissection we chose in this case, a block dissection. First we have dissected the intestine, and so as to prevent the artifacts by enmas technique and also to localize the site of perforation. So once we have started exploring the intestine, we found the site of bowel rupture with a partly sealed blackish mucus plug, and it is 1.2 cross 1 centimeter defect in the anterior wall of the cecum. And here are the pictures showing liver and spleen. You can see the anterior and under surfaces of the liver, which were coated with a greenish material. Also the under surface of diaphragm is coated with a greenish material. So we have taken this bit of intestine along with other organs for histopathological examinations, like bit of both lungs, liver and half of each kidney. And the HPA report showed the chronic inflammatory cells which have been reaching serosa, as well as the submucosa shows this inflammatory cells, and there is infarcted and denuded mucosa. So here is the HND staining of the bit of intestinal mucosa with a 4x magnification showing the denuded mucosal epithelia and focal inflammatory cells. Next slide showing, this is a 10x magnification where you can see the disrupted mucosal epithelium as well as the submucosal denudation. And this is a 20x magnification, the HND staining, showing the inflammatory cells. So cause of this, we have arrived. We have given like complications of peritonitis secondary to perforation of cecum. Coming to the discussion, the overall incidence of bowel injuries who underwent gynecological surgeries is 0.54 to 0.7%, out of which 32% of the gastrointestinal injuries occurred only in abdominal hysterectomy, common cases of injuries as we notice it is in the order of decreasing frequency from large bowel, small bowel, rectum and rarely gastrium. And cecum is more prone for the rupture due to the amount of pressure required for its rupture. This has been studied in cadavers actually. And from literature we have noticed that 100% of cecal injuries were reported in patients who have underwent total abdominal hysterectomy, and 1/3 of the cases can be diagnosed during the surgery, and repair can be done immediately either by intestinal closure or resection for the extensive injuries. And the mortality rates in cases of delayed diagnosis is as high as up to 21%. And this is a figure showing the frequency of bowel injuries intraoperatively, 37.5 during entering the peritoneal cavity, while 35.2 during adhesiolysis and pelvic dissection, followed by laparoscopy, 10.2% and 8.6% in both DNC and vaginal surgeries. So what went wrong in this case? The patient has been referred for two hospitals where there is a delay in diagnosis, as the patient showed the symptoms of abdominal intestinal obstruction as well as peritonitis. Still they haven't approached the damage control surgery, and we have also noticed documentation errors. I would like to show the operation notes taken from first hospital submitted by the IVO to us, and this stated that there is pan abdominal hysterectomy done, but however the doctor has mentioned the sutures have been removed and wounds healed with primary retention. But when we noticed the sutures were still intact, and this is the CT scan report, CT abdomen. They have identified that it is post-hysterectomy status with moderate SFS and pervertic ileus, or as well as squamous subacute intestinal perforation. And this has been taken on the day of admission into the Government General Hospital. But still they have treated the case for 9 days. Still they have delayed in re-explorating the abdomen. Maybe the patient could have been revived if the intervention has been done earlier. So to conclude, to err is human, but to accept and intervene timely is divine. According to Tiwari, Medical Negligence in India, a study, a critical study done in India, so he quoted like, as long as the doctors perform their duties and exercise an ordinary degree of professional skill and competence, they can't be held guilty of medical negligence. These were my references. Thank you.
Questions?
Complications of peritonitis secondary to perforation of cecum. What is cause of death? What is the primary event that led to the sequence of events?
Sir, this is the perforation of cecum.
That is the cause of
death. Medical certification of cause of death, MCC requirement. What do you think?
Government hospital, who is a negligence, or it is a compound negligence where both are involved?
Maybe it is a composite negligence where two or more doctors are involved.
Okay, then to what degree? To what degree they are involved? Whose negligence resulted more towards the death? See, this is what has to be
the
told by.
The
magnitude of the negligence, because when you say more than one doctor is involved, then the court, if it's not compensate, they have to divide the percentage. Who has to pay more and who has to pay less? Then you have to say who is the main culprit?
Operating surgeon or middle
operating
middle
surgeon or the second doctor? Okay, definitely not the doctor who has done the postmortem, not you. Okay, apart from you. And what is you quoted from Tiwari? So you want to show it on the negative side or the positive side? You want to go? You want to go?
Negative side.
Negative side. to be on the safe side, right? Okay, right.